So if you've read a few history books, you probably know that the beginning of the German invasion into the Soviet Union was quite messy for the Soviets. Their army was, well, not in the greatest condition to say the least. One of the things which proves this would be the initial use of the Ilyushin IL-2 ground attack plane. The IL-2 was first used in combat over the Berezina River, just days after the German invasion started. The planes were so new that the pilots had no training on how to fly them properly, or how to even use them in combat, nor did the ground crew have any idea on how to service or rearm them. The pilots had only learned how to take off and land, but none of them had fired the weapons or practiced any tactics. Some of the pilots had never even seen the rockets of the IL-2 before, and now they were supposed to use them in combat. This short clip from one of the best documentaries about the Eastern Front I've ever seen explains this quite well.
Flew off on their first mission.
А как целятся при пуске РСов?
Направляешь перекрестие на цель и жаришь.
Greetings to Mosasaurus, who actually recommended this clip to me. And by the way, I'll put the link for the documentary here in the bio in case you want to see it as well. Anyways, as Soviet pilots got more familiar with the IL-2, they improved their tactics. For example, instead of flying straight and low at 50 meters, they kept the target to their left and attack with a slight turn and a shallow dive at a 30 degree angle. They usually flew in groups of 4 to 12 planes. Looking at the armament, the IL-2's RS-82 and RS-132 rockets were powerful enough to destroy armored vehicles in one hit, but they were not very accurate, so experienced pilots preferred using the cannon instead. Another powerful weapon of the IL-2 was the high explosive anti-tank bomblets called PTABs, which stands for Anti-Tank Aviation Bomb. These PTABs were small, weighing 2.5 kilograms, 5.5 pounds, with 1.5 kilograms, 3.3 pounds of explosive charge and could penetrate 60 to 70 millimeters of armor. The IL-2 could carry up to 192 PTABs in external dispensers or up to 220 in internal weapon bays. Basically, those PTABs were heat rounds which would be dropped on the roof of enemy tanks and penetrate them from above. So this was a long intro. In this video, we're gonna talk about the Soviet PTAB bombs of the IL-2. So hello and welcome and enjoy this video. Because of the fact that the PTABs could penetrate the top of German Panther and Tiger heavy tanks with relative ease, they were used in large numbers. When all 192 bombs were dropped at once, almost every vehicle within a 15 by 70 meters area was hit. Because the tanks weren't as heavily armored on top, these bombs could disable pretty much any tank in the war. Those bombs were effective as hell. During its first use on July 2, 1943, 8 IL-2 planes destroyed 15 tanks from a group of 70 German tanks. In later missions during the Battle of Kursk, on July 15, 1943, 4 IL-2 planes attacked 25 tanks, destroyed 7 and damaged 4. On July 16, 1943, 23 IL-2 planes with PTAB bombs destroyed 17 tanks and another 40 vehicles. Yeah, so I guess that's alright, isn't it? PTABs were introduced in 1943 and were widely used by IL-2 planes and also by Yakovlev Yak-9 fighters, especially the Yak-9B fighter-bomber version. Even the Polikarpov PO-2 could carry and drop PTABs. The number of PTABs dropped kept increasing massively over time. As usual, when talking about Soviet stuff, especially during World War II, we can't expect anything less than numbers going into the thousands. In the case of the PTABs, they go into the 7 digits. By the end of 1943, Soviet records showed that 1,175,340 PTABs were dropped. In 1944, that number went up to 5,024,822. And in the first 4 months of 1945, another 3,242,701 PTABs were used. The Germans responded to this new weapon by spreading out their tank formations. On March 5, 1944, the man with the nice mustache allowed the use of the German version of the PTAB, the SD4HL, which had been kept a secret until then to avoid letting the enemy know that they had a similar effective anti-tank weapon that could be used from the air. Doesn't make much sense to me, to be honest, but anyways. Now, World War II wasn't the only war in which PTABs have seen action. In the current war in Ukraine, they have been used as well. As we all probably know, drones in the Ukraine war were quickly developed into a type of low-cost FPV loitering munition. A heavy-duty version of the Escadrone attack drone was modified to carry a 2 kg, 4.4 pounds PTAB 2.5 anti-tank bomb. And well, it's very effective against a tank's weak spots. The Escadrone is highly maneuverable and has successfully targeted the less protected areas of Russian tanks. How this tactic really worked, I don't know, but I'd like to see some footage. Anyways, that was all I had to say for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you think I said anything that is not right, or you think I should have added any additional information to this video, please let me know in the comments and share your knowledge. Besides that, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.
Close. Capture the zone.